EOH is Engineering Open House. It's a collection of pretty much a science fair on a college level. So you've got everything from people blowing things up and breaking things to people designing things and building them.
So you're running EOH and Siebel. How big of a challenge is running Siebel?
It's mostly an organizational challenge, I guess. It's hard to kind of get everybody's contact information from actual EOH and then bring it up here and try to get everyone sorted and make sure they have everything they need. It makes it hard just because there's a lot of people working on EOH and then kind of like separating out Siebel and trying to get everything to work within Siebel. It's kind of tricky, making sure that everyone's on the same page. But other than the organizational stuff, everything else seems to be going well.
What's Siebel like before the event?
So everyone's here working on projects they decided they were going to start like months ago and actually started probably that night. So everyone's trying to pull everything together and coming up with new ideas, and it's absolute chaos. And people are always trying to find food and stocking up on caffeine and trying to pull everything together. And then miraculously, by 8 a.m. on Friday, everything is pulled together, and it looks like we've spent months on a project that really took, like, maybe a couple of days.
So I've pulled a bunch of all-nighters, actually. I didn't sleep really Thursday night, and my sleep schedule was all messed up Friday. And earlier in the week, I also pulled one or two all-nighters.
And what did you work on?
I worked on multi-touch gesture recognition for the Tachi table.
What we do is we take in the information from Tachi's multi-touch surface and process it in a way such that we can classify the type of gesture that a user might draw. For example, square, circles, a spiral, zigzags, so just basic shapes.
All right, this is Kinect Wizards Dueling. It's a multiplayer Kinect game that we have written. You're a wizard and you can fire magic at your opponent and deflect back at them. It's really cool. As the game progresses, when you're firing a shot, if you reflect it, it gets stronger.
I'm gonna look beautiful for this. Like sleep deprived. So it's pretty much a Twitter sentiment analysis bot, and they will, you know, send a tweet to ACM Sig Music, and we'll analyze the sentiment of that, so it'll be positive or negative, and then music will be generated from that. So it's pretty much live music that reacts to how people react to it.
My favorite exhibit is basically that whole room of quadcopter lights, Tachi, all that exhibit, because I think they all go together really well, and it just kind of makes the whole room look cool. So you're standing looking at the music, and then you look over, you see all the quadcopter stuff, and it just kind of blows your mind that all that is going on in the same room.
So these lights here are RGB LEDs. They're ultra bright, and they're connected to Arduinos up here. And the Arduinos are then being controlled by our server over here. And each of these is individually assigned, and they're wrapped in these beautiful origami balls that one of our wonderful ACMers, Jessica Metro, has designed.
So this is Tachi, and it is a multi-touch table, kind of like a giant iPad. And so the way it works is we started off with an LCD television, and we took off the LCD and the backlight, and in the corners we put in these infrared lasers. And what happens is when you touch, the infrared laser hits your finger and it bounces down. And then under the screen there's two cameras, and they look for the infrared light. And when they see infrared light, they know it's a touch. So then they register a touch there. And that's Tachi.
So we've been working on a neural headset controlled quadcopter. So you put this headset on your head and it can read your brain waves, but we didn't implement anything with that. Right now we just get the gyro information. So it just knows which way you're tilting your head. So if you tilt your head one way, then the quadcopter moves accordingly. We had everything with that working by 7 a.m. before EOH, and then one of our motors burnt out. So then we couldn't do any live demos, and we couldn't test anymore or even try to get it better. So luckily we were filming a little bit, so we just played a video during the day and answered questions. But you can't have EOH if nothing goes wrong.